Hello friends, welcome to my online tutorial. My name is Pranav Shukla. This is English class and today we are going for NCERT 9 English. And our today's concern is the poetry, The Road Not Taken. Friends, the poetry on Road Not Taken by Robert Frost is also my personal favorite. Is Robert Frost's poetry is obviously a small one, but with a very huge message behind it. It is truly a landmarking poetry and gives a very important message of life. You might have gone through this poetry earlier, even in the 8th standard. It comes also in the further standards. So hardly any board or any textbook is seen without this poetry. So you can understand the weightage of the poetry. So friend, let's discuss the storyline of the poetry, its agenda or purpose behind the poetry, its message after it, and something about Robert Frost. Robert Frost, one of the most popular poets in the world, almost got the acclamation of being the national poet of America, highly popular in America as well as in the world. Friends, this poet is a bit different from the other ones. He believes that poetry is something beneath the words. Poetry is something beyond the words. In any work of art, what is unsaid is the real work of art. So poetry itself is also a work of art, and what is not apparently said, what is not surfacically said, would be the real poetry. So again, this poetry comes with the same kind of message, with the same kind of poetic thinking. The poet has used in this poetry a great imagery. In all the cultures, in all the languages, moving ahead in the life is called as walking on a path of life. So this path or road of life is actually symbolically used to describe, to narrate, to indicate the career, the choice of career that we make in the life. So friends, poetry is all about the choices that we make in our life. The choices that we make in our life really define us. It justifies our life. It gives a real dimension or direction to our life. So that choice actually make us and mar us as a persona. So it is very important to make correct choice in the life so that later in the life, you should not regret upon you. So what kind of choice we should make in our life? That is a very debatable question. It depends on person's mentality, thinking, intellectual ability, its personality. Most of the people in the world would like to live in the comfort zone, would like to do what is done by the others. They have the flock-like mentality. They want to do only what is tested, where there is no risk, there is no experiments. So they would like to be in the comfort zone. They don't like to invite risk in their life. And as a result, they are one of many. So, apart from certain friends and relatives, they are unknown to the world. And they live their whole life in a kind of dissatisfaction that they have done nothing in the life. They have done something which is quite common. And they might be jealous. They might be very much charmed by the name and fame and success of the other people. But they forget one thing. If you look at those people who are highly successful, those who earn name, they're almost immortal regarding their name. Even if they die, the name remains immortal in the hearts of people. They are the part of history. People study about them. People study their lives, learn a lot from their lives. So if you look at the lives of these people, you will just come to know that these people have taken some risk, calculative risk in their lives. They have done really something different away from the ordinary path adopted by the people. They are pioneers. They are path breakers. And they invite risk in what they do. They want to make a difference. They want to do something differently. They want to do something different from the others. And this might lead them to failure. But according to them, failure is a way of learning. So failure is not a failure. But not trying something different might be the failure for them. So these people really, by experimenting, by taking risk, by testing something new, by making some odd choices, making a difference in the world, and are remembered by the people, by the world, for eternal time. So it depends what you want to be in the life, whether you want to do something in the comfort zone, something very ordinary done by the others, and would like to live a very peaceful, restful, and a very comfortable life, and you die unlamented, unknown, it's your choice. But if you really want to do something immortal, you want to earn name, fame, you want to be remembered by the people eternally, then you do something different, something risky, you do something really new, and want to, and you should establish an example for the others. So this is the poetry for those people. This poetry has got a little ambiguity at the end. If you just know the story, you will definitely come to know that. The whole story is something like that. A traveler enters a wood early in the morning. He wants to go to a certain place. And when he enters the wood, as it is autumn time, the whole wood is covered with yellow leaves fallen from the trees by being ripened. And as you know, woods are not invaded and passed through by many people. So there are no roads like the way we have in the urban area. But there are roads. But these roads even are covered with those leaves. Now the traveler comes to a juncture in the wood where he has got two paths. And now he has to make a choice whether to go to the first path or the second path. The first path was already used by many people ahead. Normally people walk on that path only. So that road was quite taken and used one. It is worn out by the people many a times. So there is a guarantee that it will definitely take you to the destination, as it is used by people again and again. So it is in a way a surety that it will definitely lead you to the destination and get you out of the woods. So he had seen that road for a long time. He took his time. He saw that road until it was turned and lost into the undergrowth. But he did not take that road so suddenly without thinking, as it is quite common and used one. The other road was there. It was not quite worn out. It was still having grass upon it, so it is less trodden. So it indicates that it has not been used by the people. People have not traveled upon that road quite many times. So it is hardly used, rarely used, not used much, or almost not taken by the people much. He thinks about that road and he feels that it might be risky. It might take him to the destination or might not even. So amidst all the uncertainty, insecurity, risk, he gives himself a little time to think and ultimately selects the second road that was not taken by the people much. And is traveled upon that road. Though it was a morning time, both the roads were covered with leaves, so one could hardly see any road clearly. So for him it seemed to be the equal opportunity, because both the roads were not clearly seen. So for the traveler, both the roads are equal at this juncture. So he thought he would take the first road another day if he fails to walk on the second road. And he was unsure he would be able to come back or not. But if he is able to come back by being failed upon that second road, he would take the first road. But that would be the second choice. First road would be the second choice. And right now he chooses the second road, which was risky and not taken one by the people much. So he was having a doubt whether he would be able to come back. So it seemed to be a risky one. But he feels that if he walks upon that road, he might experience something new. He will learn something new. He would find out another choice in the life to reach the destination. And after taking that road, he might be telling after ages to the coming generation that he had got two roads as a choice, but he had taken the road not taken by the people much, and it might lead him to success, to the destination that he really wanted to reach, and would be telling the generations in the future that that odd choice had made all the difference in his life. So here we have the ambiguity, friends. By walking on a risky road, by walking in a different road, which was not taken by people much, whether he had reached the destination, and we are yet to know whether this road had made really a difference in his life, and the difference that has been made by that road, that choice, had been negative or positive, whether he got failure and he's regretful about that, or he had got success and he's very proud of, about that. Now, it depends on the personality of the poet, the time phase he has written this poetry in, the kind of success he has got in the life. So to think practically, by knowing Robert Frost a little, having seen his lifespan and his ups and downs of life from my personal study about Robert Frost and the kind of timing of the writing of this poetry, I, friends, come to the conclusion that we have to derive the positive message out of the poetry. Because Robert Frost belonged to a very wealthy, well-off family. He could have chosen his father's business, but he had taken a very odd path. He'd gone for the poetry where his father belonged, where his father believed that poets didn't have secured future. But he had taken the road not taken by people much. People were not going for poetry writing in those days. Still, they do even in this time. But he had taken that road of writing poetry. And today we remember him as a great poet. Apart from this, he has seen lots of ups and downs in his life. If he had gone to his father's business, as we don't know the name of his father, he might not even have known the name of Robert Frost, but today we know him. The whole world know him. America worship him. And he's become immortal in the hearts of readers. So his choice of going for a very odd career of poetry writing has made all difference in his life. So deriving from the experience of the poet himself, he come to the positive conclusion that the road not taken can lead you to a very satisfactory life full of contentment, that you have done something really different. You are a path breaker, you are a landmarking person, and you get name, fame. And if you don't even get the name and fame, you'll get the satisfaction within you that you have not been the part of flock, part of blind followers. You've done something really risky, something different, and you are different from the others. You're not ordinary, and that gives you huge satisfaction within you. So this is what the story and the message behind the poetry. And I hope you strike the poetry and take it to your life also. So now let's read the poetry word to word and discuss the question answers. Sorry, friends, to have you on the hold for a time. So this is Road Not Taken by Robert Frost, of course. So the traveler enters the wood and he finds two roads that diverge in a yellow wood. You can understand yellow wood is not yellow, but as the leaves have become ripened in the autumn season and fallen upon the soil of the wood and makes the wood look yellow. So it is transport epithet that we have. There were two roads diverged, separated from a certain point and going to the different directions. So two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and he says he was one person and could not travel on both the roads, and sorry I could not travel both and be one traveler long I stood. So he was taking his own time to decide what road he should take. So he stood for a long time and judged the roads. He had seen the first road that was taken by the people much, and looked down as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. He had seen the first road until it lost into the undergrowth. Undergrowth means thickly grown plants and shrubs and trees, and all the bushes would be called as undergrowth, jhadi. So he had seen the road as far as he could see until it was lost into the undergrowth and tried to judge it. Now, after taking his long time, he decided to go on the second road, which was not taken by the people much. Then took the other, just as fair and having perhaps the better claim. See, these two lines to be understood very quick, very nicely, friends. it is quite baffling. The Pharaoh was, of course, the first one, fair in the eyes of ordinary people. It was quite used one, quite clear of the grass. So it was having the surety it would take to the destination. But he was the man who believed in doing something different. So for him, the road which was not trodden much, which was still having some grass on it, which was not taken by the people much, inspired him to go for some experiment in the life, taking some risk in the life. So that kind of person finds that kind of road even fair enough to allow him some experiment, to do something different, to do something adventurous, something matures him. So he found that road very fair. And on the contrary, even much more than that, he found the second road, which was quite risky and not trodden one much, had a better claim. It was, the road might be claiming that I'm worthy enough to be walked on than the road which is quite commonly taken by the people much. So then took the other just as fair and having perhaps the better claim, because it was grassy and wanted wear. It was still grassy. Grass means if you just walk upon the road, because of your footstep and much walking makes it worn out. So if grass is there, that means the road is not quite used. Not many footsteps have trodden upon the road. So this road seemed to be grassy and wanted wear. Wanted wear means wanted to be used, yet to be used more. So that shows that it was not used by the people much. People might have not found it quite worthy enough to walk. It might have not led the people who already walked upon this road to the destination. And this reason why people might have not or might not be using it quite often. So it might be risky. Those who already passed upon that road might find the road. So those who regularly pass upon these roads, they find both the roads almost same. Even the road which is taken by people much is same for them, as well as what the risky one is also the same for them, because they have tested both the roads. There might be some risky people. It might be the people who really wanted to believe doing something different, just like the author, just like the poet, of course. So because it was grassy and wanted wear, though as for that, the passing there had warned them really about the same. So those people regularly passing this road, they might have used both these roads in the same way. But the one who is very beginner, the one who is for the first time to this wood, like the poet, might be very much baffled, might be very much confused. And the people like poet might choose the second road, which is quite risky. So now as far as the poet is concerned, both the roads in the morning equally lay, because as he might be the first one in the morning. So no one has used either of the roads. So roads are still covered with leaves, and no one has walked upon the road, removed the leaves and made the black or the dark road visible. So both that morning equally lay in leaves. No step had trodden black. No step had walked upon those roads and made them black. The soil, dark one, is made visible over there. And I kept the first road for another day. This is the interjection that the poet feels while taking the second road as an odd choice and might be feeling surprise on behalf of you. So this decision might also leave you in surprise. Oh, I kept the first road for another day, the road which was quite used by the people. The fact is, yet knowing how way leads on to way. See, the line is very difficult to understand. When he had taken the second road, he was yet to know how that way, matlab that road, would lead him to a destination. So this second way is actually the destination where he really wanted to way. The way we say, ke pata nahi ye cheez mujhe, matlab ye jo meri choice hai, mujhe kis raaste pe le jayegi. Yahan pe raasta means the destination. It's a change of name, metonymy. Yet knowing how way leads on to way. Matlab I was yet to know how this way, matlab how this road that was not taken by the people much or almost not taken by anyone would lead him to his way. Way means his destination. And he still was doubted. And he still doubted if he should ever come back. Matlab he might find some risk upon the road and that might be fatal, might take his life, might bring him to failure. So he was still in doubt whether he would be able to come back by walking on the second road not taken by people. But anyways, he says, he feels, if I walk upon this road, I would be the one who would be regarded as someone who has done something different in the life. And that would give him a lot of satisfaction. He would be able to tell the coming generations that he was given two choices, he had taken odd choice, done something different and risky, and that really gives him satisfaction, and later he's quite ensured that he would get success and that would make all the difference in his life. So in the last stanza, he shows his confidence. He says, I shall be telling this with a sigh. Sigh matlab deep breath. It is a sound basically, is a natural sound word, onomatopoeia is there. But this sigh word is used differently at different places. Sighing can be done in anger, sighing can be done in relief, sighing can be done in pain, sighing can be done in regret. But here the sigh is sigh of satisfaction, relief. I shall be telling. Somewhere ages and ages hence. Hence matlab from hereafter, in the future. Ages and ages matlab ages, one cannot live for ages. It is an exaggeration. It is hyperbole. But at the after the long time from this experiment or this incident, in the later his age, at the old age, recalling his experiences of the life, will be telling the coming generation that he had got two choices, he had got two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by or not traveled by anyone, and that has made all the difference. And that has made all the difference. So the difference is a difference that is quite positive. You'll be successful in the life. You would be not regretful for taking the odd road not taken. And that road not taken, that choice would make the whole difference in his life. It would change his dimension, way of life, would bring him name, fame, success, and more than that, the satisfaction that he has done something different in the life. So with a positive note, we end the poetry. Let's now go for the question answer. So the first question, friends, is where does the traveler find himself? What problem does he face? So build up the introduction. Okay, Road Not Taken by Robert Frost is a poetry which gives a very important message of life it talks about the choices that we make in the life, and that really defines us. So here the poet uses the imagery of a wood and the roads in the wood to make us understand and get the message that is quite important for the life. The poetry begins with the entry of a traveler in the woods that is yellow because of the ripened leaves have fallen upon the soil of the woods. And he comes to a juncture where he finds two roads. One was quite trodden by the people much, and the other one was less trodden or not taken by the people much. So here he stands and decides which road he should take. He saw the first road for a long time until it lost into the undergrowth. And then he had made the choice of the second road, which was yet grassy and wanted wear. So that proves that the poet might be believing in somebody who wants to really make a difference, believes in doing some adventures or ventures, and wants to be called as somebody who's done really what, something different, and he really wants to make a difference in his life. Discuss what these phrases mean to you. A yellow wood, as you know, already explained, yellow wood means the wood with the ripened leaves which have fallen upon the soil because of autumn season, and that makes the wood look yellow. It was grassy and wanted wear. Second, so grassy and wanted wear. This is about the second road, which had still some grass, and that proved that the road was not taken by the people much. It was not trodden by the people much. So some grass had been left out over there, and that makes the road untrodden, not taken by the people. The passing there, it is about the people who frequently pass through these woods and might have taken both the roads, and for them, those roads are equivalent. Nothing, no road was much used, or no road was risky on venturesome, because they have experienced both the roads. For them, it is the same. Leaves no step at trodden black. It is about the second road again. It is about both the roads. As the traveler entered in the morning, and it seems as if no one has entered before him. So both the roads were covered with yellow leaves, and no road was exposed for the travelers. So it is about those two roads. They have never been walked, especially the first one. So no one has walked upon the first one and made the soil visible, which was black or dark. How where leads on to where? It is about the second road, which was the choice of the poet. The poet here says that though he takes the second road, but he does not know whether this road would take him to his destination. He is yet to know how way leads on to way, matlab how this way, this road would take him to his destination. And he was not even quite sure whether he would be able to come back or not. Is there a difference between the two roads as the poet describes them in stanzas 2 and 3? Initially, as the poet describes, there were two roads. One was quite used one by the people. It was quite black. There was no grass. The second road was still grassy and wanted wear. In the second stanza, when we come to know that it was a morning time, and traveler might be the first one to enter the wood, and it seemed as if no step had trodden those roads, and the first road has not been exposed to the travelers and still looking covered with leaves. Its black soil has not been exposed. So both the roads are in the same condition, especially in the morning. In the last two lines of the poem. So again, the same thing, friends. In the earlier, they were different. The differences had been described, and as they were in the morning early, so they were covered with the leaves. So there was no difference. They were equally laying on the woods and hardly been seen by the traveler. What do you think the last two lines of the poem mean? The last two lines where the poet says, I took the one less traveled by and that has made all the difference. So again, you write down the whole story and the difference that he feels. So obviously you have to go for the positive note that he has taken the road, not taken describing the whole process before he had chosen the road. The road that he had taken was quite risky. He was not sure was able to come back. It was grassy, wanted where, and he did not know even how that way would lead him to his destination. But he was quite sure that after ages, in the future, he would be telling the coming generation that he had taken the road not taken by people much, and that has made all the difference. That has made him very much satisfied with his choice. He might have earned the success, name, and fame, and might be proud of his choice. So the poem ends with a very positive note of a positive difference that has been made by that choice done by the road, by the poet of the road not taken. So friend, this is all for the poetry, the road not taken. I hope you understood. Still one thing is left out in the poetry, that is poetic devices, figures of speech. So when you come to the live class, the tutorials, we'll discuss it after explaining all the figure of speech, the definitions, the usages. Then we will solve this poetry as far as the figure of speech are concerned. So thank you. That's all for today.